But I'll finish looking around this zone first. Well, I've taken care of them. Where's my reward, Jaunt? Oh, nothing. We've killed these guys. You figured you'd be happy. There's no response.
Look out below! Above! Sideways!
Wish we could take this one, too. I'm afraid to get too close to these, things. Oh, there's a what? An Orth Faung. Oh, he sounds familiar.
All right.
Is he one of the guys we're looking for? The cask from which Artaglio fills his flagon is made with staves of dark wood. Sinsteel bands hold the barrel staves tight, and you can see the dents in the sinsteel with some sort of ornamentation has fallen off. Inside, dark, spiced alcohol sloshes. Well, I can't do anything with it, but leave it alone. Orth Faung. Well, I can read about the dead person. Artaglio. Artaglio is a deserter in one of the armies of the Endless Battle. A former captain, he and his mercenary company, Artaglio's Irregulars, make their camp in Churgeon Slump, a fetid slum in a fleshy pocket of the bloom. Artaglio wears blue and silver finery and keeps his breastplate and weaponry shiny and well-polished. He is always accompanied by his men, including his former sergeant, Bernard. Well, you could change all this to past tense now. So, we had a new journal thing. Yeah. Artaglio told me that a patrol recently passed through Churgeon Slump. They were headed for the old slave block. Kian. Oh, Delny and Vrung, that's what I'm looking for. That's why I wanted to know. Okay. Someone mentioned this guy, it was just a plain Churgeon. He was over there. Oh, Orth Faung. Someone mentioned him to me. Don't remember who. You see a tall, nervous man pacing back and forth. His hair is a mess, his clothing stained with food and chemicals. His left eye is an engraved orb of metal, and you can hear it whirring from a distance. He casts fretful glances all around the space, as if waiting for someone or something. Do I know you? He peers at your tattoo, then at your face. You seem vaguely familiar. Perhaps I've seen you somewhere before. My name is Orth Faung. What can you tell me about yourself? I was a researcher at the Order of Truth, but they objected to the work I was doing for, a friend. Suffice to say that it's not going well, and I can't talk about it to anyone but him. Can't you tell me anything more about yourself? Nothing that I am comfortable sharing. He gives you a weak smile. I'm certain you understand. Nah, not really. You're doing research for a friend? Will you tell me his name? I suppose it doesn't matter. His name is Aligern. Perhaps your face portrays a sense of recognition, or the Aeon Priest is just unusually perceptive, for he immediately brightens. You know him, don't you? Perhaps if you can get a message to Aligern, ask him to meet me here, or bring him here yourself. It's extremely important that I speak to him. Yeah? Let him finish looking around here. I'll bring him in here. See what we can do. What are you doing in this place? I seem out of my element, do I? It's the robes. He plucks at the rich fabric, which is far too clean for the bloom. I needed a quiet place to continue my research project, somewhere I wouldn't be disturbed. I'm not the first Aeon priest to end up in the slump, though you wouldn't know it to look at these people. At least there's an educated community here, of sorts. The Order of Truth objected to the work I was doing. I needed a quiet place to continue my research, and this was the closest thing to a community of scholars that I could find. What happened to your left eye? This? Oh, nothing. I was doing some research in the Order of Truth and found this delightful apparatus. I thought that it appeared to be a prosthetic device, and as I was studying it more closely, it leapt onto my face and devoured my eye. Then it mated itself with my visual cortex. Good God. The pain was tremendous, of course, just blinding, if you pardon the phrasing. But when I awoke, I discovered that I could see in multiple spectra, discern remarkably small objects, and occasionally expand my consciousness into other dimensions. Or perhaps those are just the headaches paired with euphoria. Whatever the case, it was a worthwhile sacrifice, and I hardly ever noticed it's there before. Anymore. Just the usual accidents one should expect when tinkering with the Numenera. Farewell. Children. I can make you pretty, so pretty. Just let me cut your face. No, it will not. The blood covering this gurney does not inspire much confidence in its owner's professionalism. Detailed diagrams of various body parts covering a membrane stretched within a metal frame. Slump dwellers.
All right.
Ahoy, slump dwellers. Heh. Watching that bully Artaglio get eaten by the maw is the best thing I've seen in years. Demery and Obervich were my last hope. My last. This Telesponsia is going to kill me. Okay. Telesponsia.
Of course.
Yeah, don't eat me, man. Apothecary. We can sell these goods. This lumpish woman has been ill-used by the years. Her clothes are tattered and gray, as if the life has been drained from them. Her face is scabrous, and when she opens her mouth to speak, her fetid breath is nearly overwhelming. She eyes you skeptically and says, "What do you want?" She thinks, "Will you look at Miss High and Mighty? Well, it's nothing good, I'll wager. At least not for us." I'd like to ask some questions. Blue tide, because I went there first. Aye, I wager you would. Here's my question first. What's a fancy looker like you doing down here? Slumming? Seeing how the unfortunates live? You don't belong, and you ain't welcome. She turns away from you and begins to hawk her wares again. With no strim for bloom, rat. A sal for gale boil? I'll have no truck with you and your thrill-seeking ilk. Nice. Alright. Yeah, look at that. Bourras. She won't talk to us, maybe Bourras will. Oh, preservation of beauty, more thing. More, addendum. This young man's beauty shines even through his grimy face and his tattered clothes. His eyes are wide and staring, electric blue, and the movements his fingers trace through the air look like birds in flight. He snaps out of his reverie and grins at you, his teeth even and white against his brown skin. On closer examination, you can see that his rags were once fine fabrics, carefully and expertly stitched. He thinks, where am I going to get more money? Hello, she looks quite affluent. He greets you with an easy familiarity, like an old companion. His voice is smooth and educated, mellifluous and soft, however you say that word. Hello, friend. My name is Bourras. Can you spare 20 shins? I'm not giving him 20 of my money. Why do you need the money? Blue tie? That's fine. Why? Why? Friend, do you remember the last time you fell in love? The sweet laughter of an infant? The taste of a tear when you hear of a friend's death? I do. I remember them even though they haven't happened to me. He stops, puzzlement crossing his face. At least I don't think they have. But no matter. Here, inside this shop, Sheen sells the essence of these experiences. If you have the Sheens, you can live them all yourself. He thinks, my family never understood. They wouldn't even try it. At least, you can live them all. You can live them until you run out of money. Well, which I have. Did I ask you for Sheens already? I could swear I did. I only need 200. He thinks, disowned me. At least I think they did. I've had several families thanks to Sheen. I'm not giving him 200 Sheens. Sheen sells the essence of every experience you could ever dream of. Unfortunately, I need 200 Sheens to live another. This is bad. We're gonna lose some gold tide. Well, we don't lose tide, we just gain other tides, which then take over that tide. I have nothing to spare today, but I do have news for you. A white automaton is giving out free essence samples in the Memavera's courtyard. We're not very good with, deception. We can only go to 75. Success, though.
I'll remember that.
Did you say for free? His eyes light up with a childish enthusiasm. Friend, I wish I could stay to speak with you longer, but I have urgent business to attend to. Namely, I need to procure some of these samples before people who won't appreciate them like I do. That reminds me of Shadowrun Returns. There are people, you end up going, well, you're basically in a slum, I think. But in this building, these people are basically, they're addicted to living out the experiences of other people. This just reminded me. You have an option to help them, stuff like that. Okay, so I guess he went off to go meet his fate. But I don't, for doing this quest, I don't see myself getting any hits on tides or anything. So my tide is gold and blue, yeah, of course. I met a young noble named Bourras who might be of interest to the Decanted. I last saw him hanging around Churgeon's Slump, begging for money from strangers. I convinced Bourras that the Decanted is handing out samples of the essences that he craves, and he set off from Emmervera's courtyard. I should return to the Decanted and see if Bourras got there. Okay. Let me just see if, make sure, because I'm going to run in there next. Because where are the other cheer? Oh, in here. Oh, there's Demaray and Obervich. Are these the people? Hold on. Oh, Delny and Vrong, not Obervich. Alright, let's go talk to, I don't know what I'm, why I pressed that. Sheen. Jolly Sheen.
Going.
He's a warlock. This table is covered with strange instruments and controls. Got tiger blood, baby. This mysterious device spews out brightly covered cubic bubbles, the results of a chemical process you can't begin to fathom. That's cool! Cube bubbles that pop. That's awesome. I like that. So I can go examine. I thought it was interact. Three sturdy metal levers jut from a mechanism affixed to the floor. Etched along their bases are a series of symbols marking each position to which the levels can be set. The levers can be set. Sheen. Hail Sheen. When she turns, you realize that the thing you had mistaken for a bundle of sticks and twine is a woman. An impossibly thin woman, her voice all angles and lines. Her arms, summer twigs. Looks like I got a female Sheen. Her clothes drape across her like sailcloth, and though her face is young, her eyes are old, old, old. Her hands are pitted and scarred from alchemical processes, the apparatus for which stands in dizzying profusion behind her. She does not meet your gaze as she greets you, but her eyes rove across your body, watching and weighing. Traveler, the shop of Sheen lies open before you. Essences distilled, draughts for quaffing, experiences delivered, a mouthful at a time. Her voice is flat, though an undercurrent in her voice sings at a register you cannot hear. What did you mean when you said essences distilled and experiences delivered? That which we eat, that which we drink, this is not the only nourishment in our lives. Without joy, without peace, without happiness or courage, existence itself becomes empty. These states I recreate, and into dull lives restore aught of glory. She looks proud for a moment. Clients come to me from across the Protectorate, the desire to open themselves to new sensation, though perhaps unpleasant. Why? I ask not. Unpleasant horizons into the depths of human experience. Some seek solace in pain or domination or unusual abilities. Were the traveler to present a gift of a unique experience, a transfusion of energy, to Sheen, arrangements might be made. She thinks, this traveler, though, scarred as she is, may have an interesting perspective. I barter experience, sensation, any state and any emotion, if I have the means. Tell me about yourself. The expression drains from her face. From the clock of Kala I hail, superiority made flesh. The city of Sada Imidu, the house above the Indigal, saw my birthright, to explore, to delve, to understand. Yet the Zelator, in his wisdom, with his implants, told my family that my researches endangered me, reduced me from an augur to a mere human. Her voice has risen to a shout, and she collects herself. She thinks, the Indigal, clear and fresh as a morning jewel. She continues, more calmly, rather than suffer legal exile, to this place I came. The bloom sought a piece of my mind, and so I took a piece of its, and from that connection comes the ability to draw essences. Clients seek me now, seek my knowledge, care not whether my modifications endanger me. Bliss. The angry cast of her eye suggests that these memories are anything but. She turns and spits into a bottle near her strange apparatus. She thinks, would trade it all for one more glimpse of the river city, the bloom, my suffering. You ask me to relive suffering? Once already have I summoned memories for the traveler. Once have I saved my hurt. Ask something else. That well runs dry. Let me see what you have for sale. Okay, she has an element of quickness. Plus one speed edge, huh? Active until next sleep. This fluted crystalline container is filled with a vapor that spirals like a vortex around a spherical epicenter, shifting in blue, in hue and velocity, at seemingly random intervals of intensity, being at one moment a gentle azure, the next a furious purple. An inhaler is attached to one end, allowing the vapors to be consumed. The sharp inhalation of essence gives a unique succor, a rush of energies that seem to slow time for the user alone, enhancing reaction speed and other capabilities. I'm not buying this edge stuff. I'm just going to look at it. Essence of the Elder Onagran, which gives you plus 4 resistance and plus 8 energy damage on attacks, active for one crisis. This tubular flask has no opening to release the essence trapped within. Instead, the flask must be cracked open to release a sparkling blue mist. Inhaling the mist will cause you to experience the last moments of a majestic Elder Onagran, swimming free in the depths of the ocean. Its two rows of eye-like organs sparkle vividly, the long, undulating, armored skin crackling with electricity. Inhaling this mist also produces a sense of lost freedom, of something great being stolen, the unfathomable comfort of the vast open sea. This is followed by a desire for vengeance. The Onagran's life was stolen, and for this, someone must pay. For the duration of the effect, you will experience visions of life as an elder Anagrin and gain a measure of the creature's strength and rage. When you speak, your voice will be echoed by clicks and squeals, and your skin will sparkle with weak electrical impulses. I wonder if that has any gameplay element. I mean, it's only active during a crisis. So, not buying that. Although I can see it's valuable. Pretty good stat increases. Essence of the Severed Tongue. Plus 30% on deception tasks, intimidation, and persuasion tasks. Active until next sleep is a cipher. A black marble with the texture of smooth obsidian, marked by minute holes all over its surface. When held near one's head, the surface suddenly becomes transparent, and a droplet of some glowing red substance comes alive within it, writhing and rippling menacingly. Once firmly placed in the ear, a din of whispering voices becomes audible. Each voice seems to be individually comprehensible. One's mind is filled with possibilities, and spoken words seem to leave of their own accord, off the tongue, controlled and steered by the voices within this bauble. Once the conversation is over, the voices cease, and the marble becomes inert. Essence of Knowledge. Choose a lore skill, permanent plus one training level to that skill. Sweet. Unfortunately, it's expensive. This essence was put into a device to be placed over the eyes, where it injects a reddish-brown liquid into the retina. God, you guys keep messing with eyes. This gives one the ability to perceive the world with another, apparently more learned, perspective. Previously unknown knowledge of the Ninth World will be available to whoever consumes this essence. Unfortunately, the effect is merely temporary and leaves one with a rather persistent and hard-to-scratch itch on the corneas. Nice. Our lore mystical? Mystical lore tells us, in the Aldea of Warum, knowledge was power. Nestled upon an ancient subterranean library, the Warumites spent their entire lives dedicated to excavating all manners of lore from its depths. Interesting how their name has, like, seems like an offshoot of war, yet they are all about knowledge. One of the greatest honors a Warumite could be bestowed was to be condensed into a pure extract of knowledge. The exact ritual remains unknown, but involves the scholar being taken down into the cheapest tunnels of the library by two of the Warumite elders. These extracts were extremely valuable and rare due to the insight they give, but began resurfacing at an alarming rate, and rumors regarding slavery have begun flourishing in the Aldeas surrounding Warum. One of the Warumites, whether a slave or not, must have passed by Sheen's shop. She must have offered her unique services to create something very similar to the extract. Interesting. That's why I read this stuff, because it's all like, you know, there's stories behind this, and it's rather strange stuff here. 1,000 years of rest. Plus one intellect edge. Active for three sleeps. So of course after that, it's no good anymore, because it's a cipher. This vial of swirling colors contains a precious liquid that Sheen gathered from a semi-immortal being after he spent thousands of years in meditation. Once injected, it allows one to awaken a higher mental process by imparting a simulation of the time this being spent in meditation. Give you more than one edge then, I think. Impure Essence. Increases the stat pool with the highest max value by 2. Decreases the other pools by 1. Interesting. So if that was the case, oh, I'm in this. Yeah, I don't want to quit out of that. But in any case, I'd gain an intellect. I'd gain one intellect. No, I'd gain 2 intellect. And decrease speed and might by 1. Blobs of muted light slowly twist and turn within this otherwise clear fluid. Or liquid, rather. You sense some limited consciousness within reaching out to you. By ingesting this essence, something will happen. Probably. That's the, like, the most... That's the least expensive one. Sarek's Essence. Looks like half of a NyQuil pill. Confers control. Forced to fight on the caster's side for 6 rounds. The large feline Sarek are known for their ability to control creatures and contraptions around them. Somehow Sheen has managed to condense the thoughts of a Sarek into this green pill-like container. Even looking at it does things to your mind. On the one hand, you're hungry. On the other, you smell ozone and rotted flesh, and your stomach turns. And finally, Essence of Bravery. +60% on attacks, and +20% critical hit chance on attacks. Actually, they're both percent. Active entire crisis. This stoppered vial contains a bright purplish mixture. The liquid within seems to glow, and it calls to something bold and courageous within you, inspiring you to great deeds. Yeah, I wouldn't want to buy this. Which one is it? This one? Because it'll increase my intellect by 2. But, yeah. Even though it's the cheapest thing, it's still more than half of our money. But you know what? I can sell some stuff. Like this mace. This verd. This maul. This club. And I'll sell the ethereal globe. Well, now we got some money, huh? I'm gonna sell the 8-fingered mace as well. Obviously not using it. Nice! Look at all that money we got. Now, I'm thinking about selling Scriptures of the Great Devourer, but don't give us back that much. And maybe we'll need it for something. I mean, it's not an oddity. You know, it's an actual something. It's like a quest item that's not mandatory. So good. That's a lot of money. I hate these gaps like this. He has a concentrated. She has regular. He has regular. I have 2 regular. Let's give it to Tyvir. So I got regular and concentrated version. Cool. Alright, so let's see what she wants to talk about with this memories here. I have many unique experiences. I can provide the feeling of overwhelming another's mind with a wave of psychic energy. Give me money for this. Her eyes widen in anticipation. Sheen has heard of such as you. Dominators and manipulators. Sheen offers his essences in trade for these energies. Your offering lowers my prices. Does the traveler accept? I do. Then step in with me. She reaches out for you as she activates her apparatus. Her hand makes contact with you. A rainbow aura settles over the both of you, and you feel a connection to her mind. Fleeting images of a grand palace arching over a river, a mad flight over polluted swamplands, and great aerial predators that swoop onto unwary travelers in a grassland that seems to have no end. You feel the familiar swirl of tidal energies begin deep within you. As the machine continues to whir, you feel her insistent thoughts pushing at your mind. The tides curl around her. The shell of her mind compresses. Her body becomes a puppet to your will, dancing to your invisible strings. Her grasp on your arm tightens as she writhes and screams, but she lets it go on and on. Finally, with a shriek, she releases her grip on your arm and fumbles for a beaker. Semi-solid bloody tears spill from her eyes, great gouts of rich and putrid scabrous tissue. Jesus. She retrieves them with her bottle, scraping the lip of the bottle up her cheeks to ensure she captures the essence completely. The apparatus winds down, and the rainbow glow fades. Sheen meets your eyes for a long moment. You bring me a familiarity, kinship in spirit. She inclines her head slightly. My wares, their cost to you is my cost to buy. Gratitude. so now I'll be a little more reasonable. Alright, so I'm thinking about getting this thing. 142. What am I at with this? So, I'll go up to... I'm thinking this is max, right? So I'll be 21, 5, and 6. Yeah. I'll get it.
These ciphers are killing me.
Oh, it's okay. All right. So 21 total intellect. Oh, my total of speed is, or was 11. So 10 and 11 for those. Cool. Alright. I don't need anything else right now. Let me just take a quick look, though. Speed edge. These things could be helpful. Permanent training level. It's so expensive, though. Intellect edge. Controlled. I mean, I have that ability. Essence of bravery. And that's the stuff we sold. Yeah, I don't need any of this stuff. I'm done. But thank you for your business. Why do you belabor me? I have no commerce with you. I wonder how I can... Is it because we asked your stuff first? Strips of bloom flesh fill the bottom of the basket. Some of them look like they've been gnawed by human teeth. Alright. Let's go talk to these guys. I didn't see this little room off to the side at first.